Despite the hectic mood among the staff at HQ, the start of the briefing was delayed. But the weary pilots, knowing full well that they must force their exhausted bodies back into the air once the order was given, weren't the slightest bit disturbed by the delay.
Hey, what are you writing there?
I just can't remember this next phrase.
Here, let me see.
Hey! The princess couldn't feed the dove that day. She was too sick.
May I take a look?
Rosgrease. The demon of Rosgrease got her, right?
You know the story?
The demon from the North Sea. I remember. My grandma used to tell me bedtime stories about it. And every time she did, I'd be too scared to go to the bathroom in the middle of the night.
Ugh.
Settle down, people.
I knew a little about that famous legend, too. When history witnesses a great change, Rosgrease reveals itself, first as a dark demon. As a demon, it uses its power to rain death upon the land, and then it dies. However, after a period of slumber, Rosgrease returns.
Gentlemen!
Excuse me, Colonel. This is an absolutely vital mission to us. As the staff advisor sent from Central HQ for this effort, I'd like to explain it myself. The Ocean Army is planning a vast offensive with the ultimate objective of occupying the capital of Yuktobania. If this operation succeeds, it will end the war in very short order. However, the Yuktobanians have attacked our beachhead with ballistic missiles from the Rim Faxi, a Sinfaxi-class submersible carrier stationed in the icy waters of Rosgrease Straits. Fortunately, our ground forces had already completed attack preparations, so despite the missile attack, the offensive began as planned. Nevertheless, we must neutralize the threat of another Rim Faxi missile attack on our ground forces.
We have a single chance to stage a successful air attack on the underwater carrier Rim Faxi. Our passive sonar has detected a transport submarine that we believe is headed for the Rim Faxi. We believe the transport sub's mission is to supply the Rim Faxi with missiles. Based on its course and speed, we've calculated its rendezvous time with the Rim Faxi. By amazing coincidence, it is precisely the same time as the zero hour of our ground attack. At this time, the Rim Faxi will have to surface to restock its missiles. At that exact moment, ingress at low altitude to avoid detection, launch a surprise attack, and sink the Rim Faxi. Once surfaced, it only takes the Rim Faxi 1 minute to rig for an emergency dive. If your approach is detected, you will only have 1 minute to complete your attack on the Rim Faxi.
Now keep in mind, there won't be any support from Arkbird this time around. This mission rests solely on your shoulders. The entire ground offensive is relying on this first surprise attack, so don't disappoint us. I want you to turn the icy Rosgrease Straits into the enemy's graveyard.
Pilots, check your plane and prepare for refueling. 1 mile to refueling craft. To go.
Fly towards the submarine fleet.
You are restricted from flying above 1,000 feet. We can't risk having our surprise attack detected.
I'm getting chills. This northern sea is where the demon of Rosgrease came from.
Rosgrease?
There's no way that could have been the Rosgrease.
Hold your chatter. Commencing com-out procedure shortly. Maintain radio silence.
Guess I'll cut off the mic and try talking to myself.
Lieutenant Colonel Mitchell, the advisor HQ. That Pickett submarine just sent off an enemy detection notice. They're in fact, he's gonna dive in 1 minute. Attack immediately!
Hey, our cover's blown anyway. I'm gonna start talking now.
Enemy planes, halt all resupply operations. Enemy planes? We're still in the middle of our mission! Damn it! How did they smell us out?
Locked on! 30 seconds to Rimfaxi dive!
Halt the resupply. Prepare for immediate dive. Hurry up. We gotta dive before the enemy does.
Damage status on enemy sub unknown.
Those bastards are diving.
This is Submarine Squadron Command. Emergency report from our ground forces in the front line. The enemy is undertaking a large-scale offensive. Attack the enemy forces with long-range missiles from the Rimfaxi. Urgent. Transmitting target coordinates.
This is Rimfaxi. We cannot comply. We are unable to launch missiles underwater due to metal damage.
Take care of the threat from the escort subs, too!
The surprise attack on the Rimfaxi was a success, and the carrier has sunk to the bottom of the Rosgrees Straits. The threat from the Northern Sea has disappeared, and the Ocean forces are on the offensive against Yuktobania.
Me? Heavens. The ace pilots who sunk the enemy submarines are right over there. And I'm the person you want to interview now?
No, it's not that. It's just that I heard you used to be a fighter pilot yourself.
I just fly freight planes for the maintenance crews now. The captain, Captain Bartlett that is, said it was time for an old man like me to quit trying to compete with the young guys. Talk about a lack of respect.
Where did you meet Captain Bartlett?
We were both shot down and we bailed out behind enemy lines in the last war. We got through the bullet-ridden battlefield and made it back to the Allied front line. I tell you, it was tough getting the Army to believe we were on their side.
Shot down? You two?
Hey, it was a long time ago. Everyone makes mistakes, right?
Oh, no, I didn't mean it that way. Even if you're not flying with those pilots, your age and experience provide a lot of support for all of them. I just wanted to tell you that. I've seen that you really listen to what they say, and you always have helpful suggestions for them.
Well, thank you.
I think they're all going to need you, now more than ever.
I'll do what I can.
These people, it's like they're walking on a tightrope that could snap at any second. They're going to reach their breaking point sooner or later.
Yeah.